हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन दैट रोज प्रोजेक्ट। दैट प्रोजेक्ट इज कंडक्टेड बाय रय शिक्षण संस्था सद्गुरु गाडगे महाराज कॉलेज कराड। माय सेल्फ इज मिसेस देशमुख एनएस। माय सब्जेक्ट इज फिजिक्स। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच थर्ड नंबर टॉपिक काइनेटिक थ्योरी ऑफ गैसेस एंड रेडिएशन। इन दैट वीडियो लेक्चर विच टॉपिक वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन। In that first is the Kirchhoff's law of heat radiation and its theoretical proof, spectral distribution of black body radiation, Wien's displacement law, Stefan's Boltzmann law of radiation. Let me move towards our first law. In that Kirchhoff's law of heat radiation and its theoretical proof, first of all we will see the statement of that. It states that at a given temperature, the ratio of the emissive power to coefficient of absorption of a body is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature for all wavelengths. That means at a given temperature, the ratio of two quantities, emissive power to coefficient of absorption of a body, it is equal to emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature for all wavelengths. Here we can see the diagram, because first of all we have to see the statement of Kirchhoff law, and then afterward we are going to learn its theoretical proof. Also this law can write another way also, the Kirchhoff law can also state it. Otherwise we can say this statement also we can write in another form. For a body emitting and absorbing thermal radiation in thermal equilibrium, the emissivity is equal to its absorptivity. See, therefore, body emitting the absorbing thermal radiation in thermal equilibrium, the emissivity is equal to its absorptivity. That means the coefficient of emission is equal to coefficient of absorption. Here we can say coefficient of absorption is equal to coefficient of emission, and here also they said same temperature for all wavelength, A lambda is equal to E lambda. Here thus, if a body has a high emissive power, such a body having the high emissive power, it has also high absorptive power. Whatever the radiant energy body is going to absorbing, same amount of that radiant energy is emitted by the body. So here we can say, thus if a body has a high emissive power, it also has high absorptive power. Now we are going to learn theoretical proof of that law. So here diagram is very necessary, Kirchhoff law of heat radiation and its theoretical proof. See, there from that diagram also we are getting some conditions. Here we are considering two bodies are there. Consider A is an ordinary body and B is a perfectly black body. These two bodies are identical in geometrical shapes and they both are placed in an enclosure. They having same unit area also. In thermal equilibrium, both bodies will be at the same temperature as that of the enclosure. Here, see there, two bodies are present there. They having the same area. Body A is an ordinary body. B is a perfectly black body. They both having same geometrical shape. They both are present in an enclosure. Here, a thermonous wall is present there. See there, same amount of heat is incident on that body. That means in thermal equilibrium, both the bodies will be at the same temperature. Whatever the temperature of body A, the same temperature is the same temperature of body B also at that time. R be the emissive power of a body. A is our ordinary body. R, only R be the emissive power of body A. R B, here we are getting subscript RB be the emissive power of the perfectly black body. Now see there, whenever their radiant energy is incident on that body, there will be absorption of that radiant energy. So here A be the coefficient of absorption of body A. Whatever the radiant energy is absorbed by the body A, the body is denoted by capital A and its coefficient of absorption is denoted by small a. If Q is the quantity of radiant heat incident on each body in unit time, that means same amount of heat is incident on that two bodies in unit time. and that same amount of radiant heat who is incident on that body, it is a Q. Next is here, QA is the quantity of radiant heat absorbed by the body A. Here, whatever the radiant heat is absorbed by the body A, it is QA. And then QA is equal to A into Q. By the last definition also we can write QA is equal to A into Q. Q is the amount of energy incident on that body. A is the coefficient of absorption of a body. QA is the quantity of radiant heat absorbed by the body A. Let me move toward the next point. Again, I am showing the diagram. Here in that diagram also we are getting the equality of A and E. A is the coefficient of absorption, E is the coefficient of emission. So here we have to see the theoretical proof. So here QA is equal to A into Q. As the temperature of the body A and the body B remains the same, the both must emit the same amount as they absorb in unit time. See there, the both having the same temperature, whatever energy is absorbed by that two bodies, whatever energy is absorbed by that two bodies, it is same. The same energy is absorbed by body A and body B in a unit time. The emissive power is the quantity of heat radiated from unit area in unit time. How much? See there, emissive power, it is the quantity of heat radiating by that body from unit area in unit time. And here also we can say the quantity of heat, radiant heat absorbed by A is equal to quantity of heat emitted by A. The quantity of whatever the quantity of heat is absorbed by body A is equal to quantity of heat emitted by body A. Next point is there. QA is equal to R. It is our first equation. Second is there, for the perfectly black body, the same equation also we can write the second. Q is equal to RP here. It is the emissive power of the perfectly black body. Q is the amount of heat which is incident on that perfectly black body. Next point is there, the theoretical proof is going on here. QA is equal to R. This is our first equation. Q is equal to RB, emissive power of the perfectly black body. It is the emissive power of the ordinary black body. Here, it is the coefficient of absorption for the perfectly, for the ordinary body. Here, diagram also important. So, I am showing here, dividing the equation first by 2. See there, first by 2. Here, we will get AQ divided by Q is equal to R divided by RB. That QQ, they both are going to cancel. Therefore, A is equal to R upon RB. We are getting the third number equation. But now here, we know this equation also we can write in another form. R upon A is equal to RB. But E is equal to R upon RB. The emissive power of ordinary body to emissive power of the perfectly black body is equal to E. So, if we are comparing the equation number 3 and equation number 4, here we will get, that is A is equal to E. It is a coefficient of absorption is equal to coefficient of emission. In such way that we are prove, theoretically prove the Kirchhoff's law. We can move toward the next point. It is the spectral distribution of the black body. We can see the graph. From that graph, we have to discuss the more points. The rate of emission per unit area or power per unit area of a surface is defined as the function of wavelength lambda of the emitted radiation. See there, the rate of emission per unit area, how much energy is emitted from that area, per unit area, otherwise power per unit area of a surface is defined as the function of wavelength. The wavelength is going to changes with the emitted radiation. The radiant energy emitted per unit area, per unit time by a black body depends on its temperature. That means the radiation per unit area, per unit time depend on the temperature of that black body. At low temperature, here we can see at a low temperature the power radiated is small and primarily lies in the long wavelength region. It will rise in the long wavelength region. As the temperature is increases, the rate of emission also increases fastly. At each temperature, the radiant energy contain a mixture of different wavelength. At each temperature, the radiant energy contain the mixture of the different wavelength. Here we are getting the wavelength. It is the black body spectrum is present there. Here it is a spectral radiation. Next, at higher temperature, the total energy radiated per unit time increases and proportional of energy emitted. That means whatever the higher temperature is there, at that the total energy radiated per unit time increases and the proportion of energy emitted. At higher frequencies or shorter wavelength also increases. At that higher temperature, see there higher frequencies or shorter wavelength also increases. There is increase in the frequency and also shorter wavelength is also going to increases. Next is the same point we are going to say with the help of diagram. Spectral distribution of black body radiation. See there Loomer and Pringsheim studied the energy distribution. They both are studied that distribution of black body radiation as a function of wavelength. Black body radiation is changing with the wavelength. Here, kept the source of radiation such as a cavity radiator at different temperature and measured the radiant power corresponding to different wavelengths. At low temperature, the power radiated is small and primarily lies in the long wavelength region. That means at different temperature, if we measure the radiated power corresponding to the different wavelength, and at low temperature what happened? The power radiated is very small and primarily lies in the long wavelength region. Graphical presentation of curve showing the variation of radiant power per unit area as a function of a lambda at a different constant temperature. Here, as the temperature is changing, that wavelength is also going to changes. Spectral distribution of black body radiation. Spectral distribution of power radiated by a body indicates the power radiated at different wavelengths. Here we can understand the power is radiated with a different wavelength. Next point, keep the source of radiation such as the cavity radiator at different temperature and measure the radiant energy. We have to keep that source of radiation at different temperature. As the temperature is changing, we have to measure the radiant power corresponding to different wavelength. At low temperature, the power radiates is small and primarily lies in the long wavelength region. Next point is that spectral distribution of black body radiation. In that same point is there. Now here we are going to see the observation from that graph. At a given temperature, the energy is not uniformly distributed in spectrum. At a given temperature, the energy is not distributed. There is no uniform energy. There is changes. Here we can see the two, three curves are there, not uniformly distributed. That is as the function of wavelength of a black body. That means it is going to changes with the wavelength. Next is there, at a given temperature, the radiant power emitted initially increases with increase of wavelength, reaches its maximum and then decreases. At a given temperature, the radiant power is emitted initially, there is increase in that power. With increase in wavelength, it reaches at a maximum, lambda max. Okay, then again it is going to decreases. The wavelength corresponding to the radiation of maximum intensity, lambda max, is the characteristics of the temperature of radiating body. We have to remember that it is not the maximum wavelength emitted by the object. Area under the curve represent total energy emitted per unit time, per unit area by the black body at all wavelengths. See, whatever the area, it will comes under that curve. What is indicating? It is total energy emitted per unit time, per unit area by the black body at all wavelengths. Next point is that the peak of the curve shifts toward the left. Here we can understand the peak of curve, it is going to shift towards the left. Shorter wavelength, that is the value of lambda max decreases. Shorter wavelength, that is the value of lambda max decreases. With the increase in temperature, if there is a decrease in that wavelength, that time there is increase in the temperature. At high temperature, the radiant power or total energy emitted per unit time, per unit area. At a high temperature, the radiant power or total energy emitted per unit time, per unit area. That is the area under the curve, which corresponding to all the wavelengths increases. That is the area under the curve, which corresponding to all wavelengths going to increases. At the temperature of 300 Kelvin, around the room temperature, the most intense of these waves has a wavelength of about 5 into 10 raised to minus 5 meter. In this way, we completed the spectral distribution of black body. Then, Wien's displacement law. In that statement is there, it is observed that the wavelength for which emissive power of a black body is maximum is inversely proportional to the absolute temperature of the black body. It is observed that the wavelength at which emissive power of a black body is maximum, emissive power, and it is inversely proportional to the absolute temperature of the black body. Lambda max is equal to 1 upon T, or lambda max is equal to B upon T. Here, what is the B? Otherwise, we can say lambda max into T is equal to B, where B is called the Wien's constant. It is B is equal to 2.897 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter Kelvin, lambda into temperature. Here the significance are there, some importance of that law. If body is heated more and more, its cooler changes its color. If body is heated more and more, its color changes from yellow to reddish, higher to the smaller wavelength. As there its temperature is increasing, see there, their wavelength is become higher to smaller. Next, this law is useful to determine the temperature of distant stars, sun, moon. Stefan-Boltzmann law for radiation. First, we will see the statement. The rate of emission of a radiant energy per unit area or power radiated per unit area of a perfectly black body is directly proportional to 4th power of its absolute temperature. The rate of emission of radiant energy per unit area or the power radiated per unit area of a perfectly black body, it is directly proportional to 4th power of its absolute temperature. From statement here, we will get equation R is directly proportional to T raised to 4, or R is equal to sigma into T raised to 4. It is Stefan's constant, so Q upon AT is equal to sigma into T raised to 4. Therefore, here we can get the value of sigma Q upon AT per unit T raised to 4, whereas sigma is the Stefan's constant. It having the value Stefan's constant 5 into 5.67 into 10 raised to minus 8 joule per meter square per second per Kelvin raised to 4. The dimensions of that Stefan's constant is L raised to 0, M raised to 1, T raised to minus 3, K raised to minus 4. Here some information is about that Stefan-Boltzmann law of radiation. We are getting one by one. If Q is the amount of radiant energy emitted in time T by a perfectly black body of a surface area A at a temperature T, then Q upon AT is equal to sigma into T raised to 4. For an ordinary body, R is equal to E into sigma T raised to 4. We are getting some formulas, they are useful to solve the numericals. If the perfectly black body having absolute temperature T is kept in a surrounding which is at the lower absolute temperature T0. Surrounding having the temperature T0, perfectly black body having the temperature T. Then the energy radiated per unit area, per unit time sigma into T raised to 4. Energy absorbed from surrounding per unit area per unit time sigma T0 raised to 4. The energy is absorbed from the surrounding having the temperature T0, and the energy is radiated per unit area per unit time sigma T raised to 4. More formulas are there. Net loss of energy by perfectly black body per unit area per unit time. Here sigma T raised to 4 minus sigma into sigma multiple by T raised to 4 minus sigma into T0 raised to 4. Sigma is taken constant. T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. For an ordinary body at temperature T, net loss of energy per unit area per unit time. It is net loss of energy by perfectly black body per unit area per unit time. It is coefficient of emission is present there. Sigma into T raised to 4 minus sigma into T0 raised to 4. Here is equal to E into sigma multiple by in bracket T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4. It is the coefficient of emission. Next point is there. If T0 temperature of surrounding is greater than temperature of perfectly black body, then E into sigma multiple by in bracket T raised to 4 minus T0 raised to 4 will be the net gain in thermal energy of the body per unit area per unit time. In this way, we are completed this today's video lecture. Also, we completed the third topic. It is kinetic theory of gases and radiation. Thank you.